folks, before we start the show this week, I got to show you this. It's a Scotty Upshaw goal against the Arizona Coyotes. But the thing about this is it's called by a Spanish announcer, so let's watch this.
Al regresa Abchal, entra posibilidad, Abchal, entra Abchal, el gol, Abchal, el gol, el gol! Goal!
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not wearing socks. You know why? Because I laughed so hard at that goal, I spilled beer all over myself. My socks were wet.
Middle, Griffin scores!
Sorry, go ahead.
Welcome to Puck Talk.
Happy November.
I'm not growing the mustache, it's already happened. I'm just going to see how long I can get it to, like, go.
Monopoly Man.
I'm Sam.
I'm Dane.
And this is what you need to know in hockey this week.
This week there were 5 suspensions handed out for dirty hits. Alex Barros with an illegal hit to the head.
Anton Volchekov with an illegal hit to the head.
Jordan Nolan for boarding.
And John Moore for an illegal hit to the head as well.
John Scott for leaving the bench. And Andrew Ferentz has a phone here. And funny enough, fighting's been down this year compared to this time last year.
Some people that are like pro fighting might say fighting's going down, the illegal hits are going up because there's not enough of that, like, keeping stuff in check.
There's always talk about the enforcers and where the enforcer role now lays in hockey. Like Toronto did, got rid of their enforcers this year. A lot of teams have followed suit.
It's definitely dying. It's definitely diminishing.
We are seeing some other physicality in the game.
And we're seeing the refs break up fights before they really happen, which is part of what they're supposed to do.
Yeah, so the refs have been told that if they can break up a fight before it happens, to do so. So we've seen that a couple times this season already.
Most notably, probably from Nuffin Aginla. I think we all know that Aginla would have beat the shit out of him.
I think that too.
Damn it.
Should we get the liquor? So all these illegal hits are leading to key injuries. Calgary has a lot of guys down. Columbus has a lot of guys down. Tory Krug doesn't have half a finger.
If you haven't seen this photo, prepare yourself, because we're going to show it right
Grab
now.
Grab a content.
Oh!
Oh my goodness.
It's falling off.
It's pretty gnarly.
So Gordie Howe this week suffered a very serious stroke and is recovering in Texas with his family, but kind of a scary incident. A lot of tributes for him in the NHL in some pregame ceremonies. So I don't know, for a lot of people, at least me, thinking about Gordie Howe, he doesn't seem super old, but he is pretty old. He started playing in the NHL in 46.
I think he ended in 80.
Yeah, which is, that's a huge hockey career.
So we do wish Mr. Hockey the best, and hopefully he makes a full recovery. I gotta poop.
Well, Dane's pooping, we're gonna have a little segment here called Leaf Talk. Welcome to Leaf Talk, show where we talk about the Leafs and how the Habs suck. Hey, how about those Leafs?
They're good.
Some more goalie controversy this week. Philadelphia goalies Steve Mason and Ray Emery. Steve Mason not doing so hot, Ray Emery pretty much killing it.
If you don't remember Ray Emery, he was pretty good in the 2000s. He led Ottawa to a Stanley Cup final. Very strong goalie. And then he got traded to Philadelphia and he had a very serious kind of a disease. It was a bone thing in his hip. People thought he might never play again. And he really fought his way back into the NHL. He's been a backup since he's returned. He was a backup for Chicago. And last season with Philadelphia, he was playing backup to Steve Mason, who played very well. But this season, Steve Mason hasn't been playing well. And Ray Emery's really stepped up. I really like Emery. He's got a lot of swag. He's like one of the few guys in the NHL that will go out and like buy crazy cars and dress in crazy suits. And like a lot of NHL guys are really modest in how they spend their money and what they do. But Ray Emery's the complete opposite. He's just a flashy dude.
It's always nice to see a backup goalie contending for the number one spot.
Yeah, the competition's always good on a team, I think. It's going to, I think, really push Steve Mason to perform better as well. And that's great.
Check out this pretty play.
And saved by Chad Johnson. Rebound, chance, shot, score! His first goal of the season! Using patience.
Schrader gets it, waits, he's waiting for something, and finally Johnson just basically toppled over.
Pretty play for a pretty boy.
The Islanders goalie waits for a bit, but then falls down like a sack of bricks. Why would you put bricks in a sack? I don't know, but that's the shot of the week, folks. Why did we decide this was a concept for a show? Why can't we just be sober and talk about hockey?
No. Tons of upsets this week.
Saturday night, the Leafs pull off a win against the Blackhawks 3-2, which seems like a bit of an upset because they got out heavily outshot, especially in the third period. Reimer made 48 saves in the win, which is nuts.
And 26 of those saves came in the third. Sabres beat Wings.
And also LA got beat by the Canes, who win their second regulation game so far this season.
And the Oilers, getting off to a terrible start, made up for it. They went four games in a row, playing pretty well.
Shut out the Habs, too, with Scrivens in net. Scrivens is
playing pretty good hockey these days. Time for the best part of the show, comments of the week.
We got a couple of good ones this week. This one is on a video the NHL posted, putting a side-by-side of Orr and Seth Griffin. Seth Griffin, if you didn't see his goal this week from the Boston Bruins, scored with the flying through the air, Bobby Orr-style goal. Very similar. And the question the NHL posed was, who did it better, Orr or Griffith? Hank Hill said, definitely Orr's. Griffin did it with the grace of a starving man trying to eat a pomegranate through a screen door. Screen doors have, like, dust on them and flies get stuck in them. And you're eating a pomegranate through that?
This next comment comes from Reddit. The post where we found out that Hurricanes won their first regulation game. Gibson 19. The beer tastes so much better when you're celebrating and not crying into it first.
As a Leafs fan, I know that feeling. So this next one's also from Reddit. It's about Phil Kessel being a speed demon.
It was against Chicago. It almost looks like the play's fast-forwarded, but it's not. It's just him. His killer acceleration.
A Habs fan with some French name said this. And imagine if he stopped eating cookies. It's true.
Funniest looking fast player in the league.
The funniest looking fat player in the league. So, question of the week.
Do you think the increase of injuries has anything to do with the decrease in fighting?
Let us know in the comments below. So that's it for this week.
Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe.
Follow us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, check out the website, puck-doc.com.
And until next week, guys.
Cheers.
Cheers.